Hey guys, this is Doris, and this is my Friday Night SmackDown recap. I tried a little bit something new today. Let me know what you think about it in the comments. If it's something you like, I will continue doing it this way. If not, I can go back to the old way. Still short clips. Tried to make the video as short as I could. Hopefully you enjoy. Thanks, guys. All right, we started out the show with Rey and Jey Uso and Roman Reigns in the ring talking about Night of Champions. This brings out Sheamus and King Corbin, which they end up going back and forth, and then that leads to a main event tag team match with Jey and Roman versus King Corbin and Sheamus. There was a little bit of physical back and forth between Jey, Sheamus, and Corbin. Throughout that whole thing, Roman just pretty much sat there and watched it go on. Jey kind of looked at Roman like he really wasn't sure what was going on with them. Then we go to the production truck. They made an announcement of AJ Styles versus Jeff Hardy. They showed Sami Zayn in the production truck saying how it wasn't an Intercontinental title match because he's the champion and he's not involved in the match. And he ends up going on the stage once both AJ and Jeff are in the ring. This distraction with Sammy up on the stage allows AJ to get the upper hand on Jeff. Once Adam and security come out to remove Zayn, AJ does attack Hardy and does control the beginning of the match. But Jeff ends up coming back a little bit. Here you see Jeff ends up using the stairs against AJ. And we got Jeff coming back and taking control back over AJ. It goes back and forth. It was a pretty good match. And Jeff went for the Twist of Fate, missed. AJ got a close pin there, and AJ ended up working on Jeff's knee again, and that worked a little bit, but Jeff was still able to control a little bit, but he does miss some of his good moves. And then of course we end up having Sami Zayn come out and get involved in the match, attacking both AJ and Jeff, which led to the match ending in a no contest. They do show Jeff having a hard time walking up the ramp. He ends up falling. They show him in the back in the trainer's room. The trainer tells him he just needs some fluids. He's dehydrated. Sami Zayn goes in the back and attacks him again. Then we have Lucha House Party coming out for a tag match with Cesaro and Shinsuke. That was a decent match. We ended up seeing Cesaro and Shinsuke in the back with the Street Profits talking about their champion versus champion match on Monday. And you will see in the match that little exchange affects this match. Lucha House Party really could not control the match. Shinsuke and Cesaro pretty much controlled the whole movement of the match. They definitely were going to win. And then we see the Street Profits up on the Titantron. This distracts Cesaro and allows Sin Cara to get the pin on Cesaro. Then we see Bayley come out. She talks about Sasha Banks and how she attacked Sasha before Sasha could turn on her. When she's on her way out, Nikki Cross comes out for a fatal four-way match, the winner to face Bayley at Night of Champions. Bayley also attacks her. We have Lacey, Alexa, Nikki, and Tamina involved in this fatal four-way match. It was a pretty good match. All four women pretty much controlled each other. Lacey and Tamina did work together off and on a little bit during the match, but Lacey kept turning on Tamina. And this match was decent. I couldn't say who really controlled more of the match. You definitely see Tamina and her size and strength difference with the other three women. But also you see Lacey showing some of her aggression, which we've seen lately from her. And then Nikki kind of keeps getting put out of the ring and doesn't spend as much time involved in the match as the other three women, but she does come back and show some of her high-flying action. Like here, she takes out the other two besides Alexa. Alexa helps her up, and then we have Alexa do the Sister Abigail perfectly on Nikki Cross. We went to a commercial. When we came back, they show Alexa kind of walking in a trance up the ramp. So that means that this is now a three-way instead of a four-way match. And for a good amount of time, Nikki was left outside of the ring due to Sister Abigail. So that left Lacey and Tamina involved in the match. But Nikki does come back to break up a pin, and she pretty much controls the rest of the match between the other two women. And she ends up getting the win on Tamina. She ends up rolling Tamina up for the win. So that means that Nikki Cross will be facing Bayley at Night of Champions for the SmackDown Women's Championship at Night of Champions. Now we have Otis facing John Morrison with The Miz at ringside doing commentary. Otis pretty much controls this match. As you see, he's got his briefcase back. So he's got his lunchbox and his briefcase at ringside. The Miz ends up pretending like he's going to get involved in the match and ends up stealing the lunchbox, which he believes has the contract in it. Otis ends up winning the match after a big splash on Morrison. He gets the pin, and Tucker ends up telling Otis how he lost the contract again. And in the back, we see Otis and Tucker. Otis says how maybe Miz did take his lunchbox, but he doesn't have the contract. He was smart enough to have another lunchbox, and what the Miz has is his actual lunchbox. Here we see the Miz find the apple core. This is the Playhouse. We now have Vince McMahon, who's in the Playhouse. We have a Vince McMahon puppet who tells Bray that he is close to losing his job and ends up putting Wobbly Walrus in charge of the Playhouse. And now our main event, the tag match with Sheamus and Corbin versus Jay and Roman. Once Corbin and Sheamus are out, we see Jay Uso come out, and it's pretty much just the three of them out in the match. Jay pretty much is in a handicap match for the majority of this match and ends up taking a beating from Sheamus and Cesaro, which is no surprise. He does end up getting back a little bit and is able to do some offense. It usually doesn't last long because usually one of the other, whoever's not involved, gets involved and it turns back into a double team. Like here, Sheamus ends up tagging in just as Corbin moves out of the way. and he ends up getting white noise on Jay. And then just as he's about to get the pin, Roman's music hits and Sheamus ends up missing the bro kick, and Jay is able to super kick him and take control, ends up taking Corbin out, putting him over the announcer's table. Just as Jay goes up to the top rope to hit the splash, Roman tags himself in and ends up spearing Sheamus and getting the pin. And it kind of, I don't know where they're going with this, but it seems like Roman's going to end up pulling this a lot. We see Paul Heyman presenting Roman with the belt. All right, guys, so let me know what you thought of SmackDown. Did you watch it? What do you think is going on with this Jey Uso, Roman Reigns storyline? Where are they going with this? Is Roman that bad that he's going to turn against his family? Is he trying to manipulate Jey and turn him into a Heyman guy? And what about Alexa Bliss? We saw Alexa Bliss hit a perfect Sister Abigail on Nikki Cross. And we see her coming more and more into her Sister Abigail character. She goes into that trance right after she hits Sister Abigail on Nikki. And we end up seeing Kalisto claim that he is the leader of the Lucha House Party. What do you think about all this? What is going to happen with Lucha House Party? Are they going to end up breaking up? Are the other two going to turn on Kalisto now that he's come back from his shoulder injury with this ego? And what do you think about the Street Profits match versus Cesaro and Shinsuke for Monday night? Make sure you let me know what you thought of it in the comments. I hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know what you think about what I did here. I know some of my commentary may not be following the match perfectly, but let me know how you think I can improve it. Should I go back to the way I did it before? Let me know. All right, guys, I appreciate you watching. Appreciate your support. And hit the like button if you like this video. Let me know what you thought of it. Peace out. Thank you very much. Love you all. Bye.